Great. So we've hopefully done the check setup and we've gotten credit for our two game over and win texts here. So now what we're going to do is select both of them by clicking one, holding control, and clicking the other. And we're going to click this check mark up here and disable them. And that's because we don't want those to be visible until the player either wins or loses. Next, what we need to do is create another UI text object, but we want to make a new one because we don't want to use that font and all those settings that we changed. So we're going to hit UI and hit text. And again, we're going to see it pop up in the middle, nice and dark. We're actually going to change this one to a value of 100. That's what we're going to set the text equal to. And we don't want to hit enter because we don't want to bump our text up. We went over that a little bit earlier in the project. And we're going to quickly do most of the same settings. We're going to align it by the center here in the paragraph section. We're going to turn overflow on for both horizontal and vertical overflow. And then we're going to bump the font size up to, let's say, how does 72 look? I think that's good. And then finally, we want to change the color because this text is going to represent our health. We're going to change the color to white just so that it's very easy for us to read while we're playing. We're also going to change the name of this object to health text. And then what we're going to do is switch back over to our scene view, tap the F key to get moved to where our 100 is in the scene here. And I'm going to use right click, WASD, and shift to get nice and far away from that. And then I'm going to move this and orient it right up here, right above our gems here, which if you didn't do those bonus steps, you won't see that. So this is the top left corner. But we're going to orient it right up at the top. Make sure we're inside these white lines. And we can double check that by switching back over to our game view, and we can see that there. And again, this text is going to be representative of our player's health. What we can do next is go to the canvas and click Create UI. And this time we're going to make a slider. And just like we did for our enemy canvases, we're going to move that into position. We're going to move it up under here. This actually is a good size by default. I think that works pretty well. I think I might actually make it just a hair bigger. And I'm going to do that by pressing R to pull up the scale tool. And I'm going to stretch the X scale. Or actually, I'll do it from the white box and scale the whole thing up quite a bit. There we go. I think that looks better. And now what we need to do is go into our slider. Look at the slider component and change our max value to 100 because just like our enemies, our player will have a max value, or our player health will have a max value of 100. We're then going to open up the slider object in the hierarchy, go to the handle and turn off that image because again, that knob looks kind of gross on our slider here. Next, we'll expand the fill area, go to fill and give that a color of green. So it looks a little bit more like a health bar. And the same thing with the background. We're going to click on that and change the color to red. That's going to give us a nice green and red color, just like our enemies, so to identify that that's a health bar and nothing else. And the last thing that we need to add is another UI text object. And again, that's going to drop it right in the center of our screen like last time. And what we are going to do is give it the same, or we're going to give it a value of 0. And instead of doing the center align like we did this time or last time, what we're going to do is do a right align. And what that's going to do is force this object or this text to always be, it will always line up with the right side of our screen. And we're going to be putting this text in the top right corner of our canvas. So we don't want to risk our numbers running off and out of the white box. So by doing this right align, we'll make sure our numbers always stay inside the edge of this box here. Next, what we're going to do is bump up our text size again to 72 or our font size. Excuse me. And then we also want to make sure we update our overflow values to be overflow for vertical and horizontal and make sure our alignment is centered. Not in the paragraph section, but in this height section, we want that to be centered and right aligned. And we're going to give this, just like our UWin text, we want this to have a nice gold color because this number is going to represent our gold. And so we can just drag that up with using our movement gizmo by clicking it and pressing W. And we're going to move that right up there. And now we have all of the information we need on screen for our player to be able to complete the game. And if you look in our game view, we can actually see all of that is accurately reflected inside of our camera there, inside our game view. If for some reason you don't see something, just make sure that it's inside of this big white box here for your canvas. So once you've got all of that, make sure you've got these two disabled, and then you are ready to move on and start getting your player's health synced up and start getting ready to finish out the game.